Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. We are going to be talking about internet etiquette today, specifically for anyone who is involved in a virtual meeting involving Greek life. This could be just a casual meeting, casual setting, an event that they have going on, things like that. I've had a couple of questions about what I would do in regards to etiquette, what you should and shouldn't do. So if anyone's interested in this video, then this video is for you. Don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, KelsTells. You can go there and ask me questions. You can also email me directly at KelsTells.all@gmail.com. And my intake prep course is still ongoing for anyone who's interested. You can sign up. I will link that information down below. For those of you who are new subscribers or new members of Greek Life watching my videos, or my videos helped you get to Greek Life, don't forget to go in the description box to order your first line jacket. That information is going to be in the description box as well. The item that is available is the line jacket by Stuff for Greeks. If you guys do not know what Stuff for Greeks is, it is a manufacturing company. They are really good at making customized jackets, shirts, anything that you want. Basically, my unboxing video will also be somewhere in this video for you guys to review, but if you are interested, please check that out. So when you're attending a virtual meeting with Greek Life, this could be anything like a meet and greet or anything specifically open to the public that you've been invited on. Zoom is usually the main, I guess, platform use. You could also be on their Instagram Live, Facebook Live, things like that, or it could be a private setting. But these are just some things that I would recommend doing for anyone who wants to know what they should and shouldn't do if they are, or if they find themselves in this type of situation. One of the questions that came to mind was, should I keep my camera on or off? And to be honest, it depends on how comfortable you feel. If you feel comfortable enough to where you feel like you can turn your camera on, then by all means, turn your camera on. Let us see your face. Let us put a face to the name if you're someone who's been messaging us for a while and we want to see who you are. If you don't feel comfortable, say you don't have the appropriate background, then it would probably be a good idea for you to turn your camera off, because you don't want to be in a messy background when you're viewing a live video or when your camera is on. For people who want to know what type of area is appropriate, anything like this, bare background, not really a mess. Well, you know, it's a little messy, but it's organized, it's clean. Make sure it's a clean background. Make sure you are looking your best. Like, I have on makeup today. Even if you don't wear makeup, just make sure that you have a clean face. And by clean face, I mean that you washed your face, your hair is done. Don't let your hair be wrapped up and, you know, tie it off. If you're a guy, make sure you don't have the little, you know, cap on your head. Make sure that you are looking your very best for these videos, because presentation is key. So make sure that you are looking your best if you have your camera on or off. If you want your camera off, I do understand some people would prefer their camera to be off because they aren't comfortable with revealing themselves just yet. They want to be discreet, and that's fine. If that's what you're comfortable with doing, then by all means, stay in your comfort level. But at some point, if you're attending enough of these events, it would be good for them to put a face to the name. So just make sure at some point that you turn your camera on so that they can do that, because that is very important. We want to make sure that the person that we're talking to is the person that we're talking to, and it's just good to have face-to-face interaction with people, especially right now during a time where, you know, physical interaction isn't really possible at this point. So bear that in mind. The next thing that I would recommend for anyone who is attending a virtual event would be to interact with your host, or interact as someone who's part of the audience. If it is that type of environment, if it's just a sit down information being provided to you, you don't really ask questions until the end, that's fine. But if it's a, you know, more casual environment where you can sit down and converse amongst one another, then make sure that you are being vocal, and that they, if your camera is on, that they see you. And I know, for example, if you are on Zoom, the person who's talking, that's the person who's profile is going to pop up on the screen. So if you want to be seen when you speak and your camera is off, the only thing that's going to pop up is your name. So while they will know your name, it will be good to see a face connected to the name. So when you're interacting, that would be good for you. So just make sure that you are interacting if it's that kind of environment. If it's not the environment where you're constantly interacting with the members of the organization, where you're just sitting down and listening, that's fine. They have chat available in most of these scenarios. So if it's open for you to ask questions, you can type your questions in the chat and do it that way. Just make sure that you're being interactive if it's that kind of environment. Now, if it's the environment where it's not so interactive, at the end, if you have a question, make sure that you have a question to ask. Always make sure that you have a question. This is why I tell people with any situation in Greek life where it's you interacting with the organization, because you want them to remember you. So make sure that you are asking questions at the end, even if it's just one little question. Just make sure that you ask a question that's going to make them think and that's going to leave an impact on them in some kind of way. So make sure that you do that. If it is something where you aren't speaking and you're just watching, then at the end, what I would recommend doing is sending a polite follow-up email to let the organization know that you, one, attended the event, that you enjoyed the event, pick something about the event that you enjoyed, and then close out with a polite, I look forward to any future events that you guys may have. And that's just something so professional and just makes people want to learn a little bit more about you as a person, because you were nice enough to, not even nice enough, you were interested enough to send a follow-up email to let us know that you enjoyed the event, or that you look forward to the next event that we host. Things like that make such a difference in Greek life, because we are looking for people who are sincere, and we're looking for people who are genuine, and we're also looking for people who would be a good fit. So if you reach that, if you meet those requirements, then you have a pretty good chance of hearing back from us. So those are just my recommendations for anyone who is interested in learning more about social media etiquette, more specifically, you know, virtual meeting etiquette. If you guys like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions or anything to add, you can just add it in the comment box below and I'll be happy to answer it for you. Check out my prep course for intake if you haven't already. I will link it in the description box. But I hope that you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.